بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. نكمل بإذن الله تعالى ما تبقى من نواقض الإسلام، نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى العافية والسلامة. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. So we'll complete that which remains from the matters which invalidate a person's Islam. We ask Allah for safety and security.
قال في الناقض الثامن.
So the author said, may Allah have mercy upon him, that the eighth matter which invalidates a person's Islam is supporting and helping the mushrikun, the polytheists, over the Muslims. And the evidence, wa dalil qawluhu ta'ala, the evidence is the saying of Allah, the Most High, whoever wholeheartedly supports them and takes them as friends is surely from amongst them. Verily Allah does not guide the oppressive people. No.
هذا هو الناقض الثامن على ما ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى.
So this is the eighth matter which invalidates a person's Islam, as the author has mentioned.
إن اعتقد
If a person believes
أن لا بد عليه من نصرة أهل الكفر على أهل الإسلام.
So if a person believes that he has to give victory and aid and support the people of disbelief over the people of Islam.
ثم طبق هذا عمليا بعد أن اعتقد. يعني يعتقد هذا وعمل بهذا أيضا. فلو اعتقد نصرة الكافرين على المسلمين فقد أتى بناقض من نواقض الإسلام. ولكن إن تأول كما في قصة حاطب رضي الله عنه، فمن الذي دافع عن حاطب رضي الله عنه؟ دافع عنه الله سبحانه وتعالى أولا، لأنه قال اعملوا ما شئتم، ودافع عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، ويجب على كل مسلم أن يدافع عن حاطب رضي الله عنه، أنه لم يكن يعتقد مظاهرة الكافرين على المسلمين. إن اعتقد أحد هذا الاعتقاد فهو كافر، نسأل الله السلامة والعافية. نعم.
So if a person believes that it's upon him to help, aid or support, to give victory to the non-Muslims, the disbelievers over the Muslims, then he has disbelieved. And this is a matter which invalidates his Islam. And if he then implements this through his actions. So if he does this in belief and in action, then he has done a matter which would invalidate his Islam. If, however, a person does this action, meaning he helps the non-Muslims or the disbelievers over the Muslims due to a particular reason that he has, not believing in his heart that this is something which is upon him, but due to a particular personal interest, like that which occurred by or from the companion Hatib radiallahu anhu, then this person isn't a disbeliever, because the one who defended Hatib radiallahu anhu was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. Allah said that do whatever you want after this. And also that the Prophet
في الحديث ورد في الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن الله طلع على أهل بدر فقال اعملوا ما شئتم. نعم. هذا حديث عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
So this Shaykh corrected me. He said that no, this was a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa taala, he was aware of the people of Badr, and he said to them that do whatever you wish after this, meaning he has forgiven you. So therefore, if Allah subhanahu wa taala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam defended and forgave Hatib radiallahu anhu for this action, then it's upon every single Muslim to also defend Hatib radiallahu anhu.
نعم. ولا يمكن أن نتكلم بأدنى كلمة في أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it's not correct for a single person to say anything regarding any of the companions radiallahu anhum.
لأن الطعن فيهم طعن في الله.
Because insulting the companions is in actuality insulting Allah.
وفي دين الله.
And also insulting the religion of Allah.
وفي رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And also insulting the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وطعنه في الصحابة.
And also insulting the Sahaba themselves.
فمن طعن في الصحابة فقد طعن في دين الله وفي رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام وفي دين الله وطعن في الصحابة وهذا واضح.
So the one who insults one of the companions, then in reality he insults Allah, His Messenger, His religion, and the companion himself.
نعم. بعد هذا.
And then after this, the author, rahimullah, he mentioned the ninth matter, which invalidates a person's Islam, and he said, whoever believes it is permissible for some people to be outside of the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just as it was permissible for Khidr to be outside the Sharia of Musa alayhi salam, such a person has disbelieved.
هل يستطيع أحد أن يخرج عن شريعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ لا. نعم.
Is it permissible for anybody to fall outside or be outside the Sharia of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? No.
فإن خرج فهو كافر.
So if a person removes himself from the Sharia of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he's a disbeliever.
وهذا قد تقدم معنا حتى وإن كان على ما كان عليه موسى وعيسى عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
And this, and we've come across it previously, that even if a person was upon the way of Musa alayhi salam or Isa alayhi salam, if he doesn't then accept the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then he has disbelieved.
قد تقدم معنا.
And we've previously mentioned
أن كل من بلغته شريعة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يؤمن به فهو كافر كائنا من كان يهودي أو نصراني أو مجوسي أو غيره.
That everybody to whom the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was conveyed, and then he did not believe in it and accept it, then this person is a disbeliever, even if he's a Jew or a Christian or whoever he is.
إذا احتج أحد بما ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى من شبهة هؤلاء. نعم.
If somebody seeks to use as an evidence a doubt that some of those people use,
يقول هؤلاء يعني أتم شبهة.
Those people, they say, they come with a doubt.
يقول أن الخضر,
they say that Khidr
خرج عن شريعة موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام.
They say that Khidr was outside of the Sharia of Musa عليه السلام.
كيف نرد على هذه الشبهة؟
So therefore, how do we repel or answer this doubt?
يكفي في الرد عليها أن نقول أن هذه الشبهة.
First of all, we say when we're repelling this doubt or answering this doubt that this is a doubt.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا رأيتم الذين يتبعون ما تشابه منه فأولئك الذين سمى الله فاحذروهم. نعم.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if you find a group of people and they always follow those things which are unclear, then those are the ones that Allah has named, and be wary of them.
لأن عندنا نصوص محكمة.
Because we have texts from the Quran and Sunnah which are very clear.
واضحة بينة.
Clear, apparent, explained.
والذي نفسي بيدي لا يسمع بي يهودي ولا نصراني ثم لا أؤمن به إلا كان من أهل النار.
Like the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that by the one in whose hand my soul is, nobody, a Jew or a Christian, hears of me and then he does not believe in me except that he is.
ثم لا أؤمن به إلا كان من أهل النار.
Except that he is from the people of the fire.
ثم أن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بعث إلى الناس كافة وكان النبي يبعث إلى قوم خاصة. نقول لعل الخضر ليس من شريعة موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, ليس من, كون النبي كان يبعث إلى قوم خاصة فالخضر ليس من قوم موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, هذا رد.
And then also another way of repelling or answering this doubt is that we say every single messenger previous to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was only ever sent specifically to his tribe or his people. And yet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was sent to all of the tribes and all of the people. Therefore, maybe it's possible that when Musa alaihi salam was sent to his people, that Khidr alaihi salam wasn't from his people.
نعم. أو قبل هذا نقول لهؤلاء أثبتوا أولا لنا أن الخضر خرج عن شريعة موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
And before this, we say to those people that first affirm for us that Khidr alayhi salam, he was outside the Sharia of Musa alayhi salam.
ثم قد جاء في شرعنا هذا ما يخالفه, فلا بد أن كل من بلغته دعوة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يدخل في دين عليه الصلاة والسلام, وإن أبى فهو كافر كفر أكبر. نعم.
And sometimes there are rulings in our religion that are in the book that contradict and go against the previous rulings, and therefore a person has to believe in them and accept them. And anybody who refuses to do so, then this person is a disbeliever.
No.
And then the author, rahimullah, he mentioned the 10th matter which invalidates a person's Islam. And he said, the 10th matter is al-i'rad, completely turning away and remaining distant from the religion of Allah by not learning it, nor acting by it. وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and the saying, and the evidence is saying of the Most High, that who is more oppressing than the one who, when the verses of his Lord are mentioned to him, he completely turns away from them. إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْنِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ, indeed we will exact retribution from the criminals, i.e. the disbelievers.
إِلَى اللَّهِ الْمُشْتَكَى,
to Allah is the complaint.
أراد أعداء الإسلام,
the enemies of Islam wanted,
أننا نبتعد عن هذا الدين,
that we remain distant from this religion.
حتى يعني ترى في هذه الأيام من لا يعرف شيء عن الإسلام إطلاقا وهو مسلم.
To the extent that you see some people in this time that they don't know anything about the religion and yet he's a Muslim.
والله ما تصدق ما أقول لكم.
He said, by Allah, you will not believe that which I say to you.
والله لا يعرف شيء عن الإسلام.
A person, by Allah, he doesn't know anything about Islam.
تسأل من نبي هذه الأمة, يقول لا أدري.
You say to him, who is the prophet of this ummah? He'll say, I don't know.
تسأل,
you ask him,
ما هو التوحيد أو أنواع التوحيد؟ لا يدري.
What is التوحيد and what are the different types of التوحيد, and he doesn't know.
هل تصلي؟ لا يصلي.
Do you pray? He doesn't pray.
هل أنت مسلم؟ يقول نعم أنا مسلم.
If you say to him, are you Muslim? He say, yes, I'm a Muslim.
ما هذا الإسلام؟
What is this Islam?
قال لا أدري.
He doesn't know.
والدي قال لي,
my father said to me,
هذا أنني مسلم,
that I'm a Muslim.
إذا لا يعرف شيء عن الدين.
Therefore, he doesn't know anything about the religion.
هذا الإعراض عن دين الله بالكلية.
So this is completely and entirely turning away from the religion of Allah.
وأراد الكفار أن نصل إلى هذا.
And the disbelievers, they want us to reach this level.
في بعض الدول,
in some countries,
يقول من هو يعني من يعمل في الدولة وكذا.
So in some countries, one of the people who works in this country said,
يقول نحن نسمح بما يسميه الناس اليوم هجرة, والهجرة عكس هذا, الهجرة انتقال من بلد الكفر إلى بلد الإسلام, لكن هم يسمون الأشياء بغير اسمها, انتقال من بلد الإسلام بلد الكفر يسموها هجرة. نعم.
He said that we hear of some people who work in these countries and they say that hijrah is opposite to what it should be. Hijrah, migration, the Islamic migration, it is going from a place of disbelief, a country of disbelief, to the country of Islam. And yet they say that now the hijrah is going from a country of Islam to the country of disbelief.
يقول هذا أن لا نريد من هؤلاء شيء, أي الجيل الأول, لأن الجيل الأول يعتبر جيل متعصب. نريد الجيل الثاني, أولاد هؤلاء, أولاد هؤلاء لنا, وأنتم لا دخل لنا بكم.
So these disbelievers, those people who plot and think in these ways, they say, look, we don't want anything from the first generation. The first generation, they're stubborn on what they are upon. But we want the next generation down. We want to get the children of this generation. The children of this generation, they're for us, meaning they're within our plots. But the first generation, we don't want anything from them.
ينشأ الولد.
So the child, he grows up.
لا يعرف شيء عن دين الإسلام.
He doesn't know anything about Islam.
ولا عن الرب.
He doesn't know anything about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولا عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
He doesn't know anything about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام.
لا يصلي.
He doesn't pray.
لا يصوم.
He doesn't fast.
لا يخرج الزكاة.
He doesn't give his zakah.
بل أنه يلبس الصليب.
But rather, instead of this, he wears the cross.
ويشرب الخمر ويصنع ويصنع ويصنع.
And he drinks alcohol and he does and he does and he does.
ما الفرق بينك وبين الكافر؟
So what is the difference between him and the disbeliever?
أنه مسلم, ميم سين لام ميم, يعني لا يعرف شيء عن الإسلام إلا هذه الحروف, لا يعرف حتى ما هو الإسلام.
So what is the difference between this person and the disbeliever? That this person is a Muslim. Meem, Seen, Lam and Meem. Meaning he knows nothing about Islam except these four letters.
هذا هو الإعراب عن دين الله بالكلية الذي أراد أعداء الإسلام أن نصل إليه ويصل أولادنا إليه. لا تعلموا شيء عن الدين.
So this is the meaning of al-i'rad, completely turning away and being distant from the religion of Allah. And this is what the disbelievers want from us and our children, that our children do not know anything about the religion of Islam.
نعم. ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله بعد أن ذكر هذه النواقض أراد أن يبين شيء من ما يقع فيه الناس، نسأل الله السلامة العافية، وأراد أن يبين أن هذه النواقض ليست محصورة بعشر نواقض. نعم، فقال.
So after this, after the author has finished mentioning the 10 maxims which invited a person to Islam, he wanted to mention other things that people commonly fall into, and that the matters which invalidate a person to Islam are not limited to 10 numbers. So he said.
نعم.
He said, there is no difference in all of these matters which invalidate a person's Islam, whether a person is doing them in jest, hazil, or with intent, waljad, or khaif, or out of fear, except if a person is mukrah, and he is compelled to do them.
ذكرنا فيما تقدم في المستهزئ.
We have mentioned previously regarding the person who mocks.
قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث جدهن جد وهزلهن جد. ولهذا قال لا فرق بين الجاد والهازل لأنه شيء واحد على ما ذكر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
We have mentioned previously regarding the person who mocks or makes a mockery of Islam or Allah or His Messenger, that the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, whereby he said the three matters, when they are done in seriousness, they are taken as being serious. And even when they are done in jest or joking or lightly, then they are still taken as being serious.
وقصد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى هنا بالخائف قال إلا المكره. الإكراه شيء والخوف أي الخوف على المناصب وعلى الجنسية مثلا. على ما تسمع من بعض الناس يخاف أن تأخذ منه الجنسية الكافرة ولهذا ينهى الأولاد عن الصلاة وعن تعلم الدين، يعني يأمر الأولاد بالإعراض عن دين الله بالكلية من أجل الخوف على الجنسية أو ما إلى ذلك أو أن له منصب في بلاد الكفر.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, in the next bit he differentiated between a person who does these actions out of fear or somebody who is compelled to do them. And he said that there is a difference between a person who does it out of fear and somebody who is compelled or forced to do an action. So for example, a person, he distances his children from the religion of Islam or he forbids them from praying. Why? Because he fears that he's going to lose a position of authority. Or he fears that his nationality is going to be taken away from them.
استثنى المكره.
And the author, the only exception he made was for the person who is compelled or forced to do these actions.
المكره اشترط العلماء رحمه الله تعالى في المكره أمور.
The scholars, they have mentioned that when it comes to a person who is forced or compelled, then they have stipulated a number of conditions.
الأول أن يكون مكره.
Number one, firstly, that he is indeed compelled or forced.
وأنت تعرف أن بعض الناس يعني غير مكره ولا أحد يكره على هذا. نعم، وهو الذي يعني يصنع هذه الأشياء عن اعتقاد وعن خوف على الجنسية وعلى المنصب أو على ما إلى ذلك. نعم.
And you find some people that despite they claim that they are compelled or forced, they're not compelled or forced. Rather, they just do something because of just fearing, again, a nationality being taken away or some type of position being taken away from them.
يعني نتحقق الإكراه.
Meaning that al-ikrah, the force or the compulsion has to be actualized.
يعني إما أن تفعل هذا أو تقتل.
Meaning that somebody says to the person that either you do this action or you'll be killed.
الثاني.
Secondly.
إلا من أكره وقلبه مطمئن بالإيمان.
That now the second condition is that the person who is compelled, as Allah says in the ayah, that the person is except the person is compelled while his heart is tranquil with iman.
ولا أحد يدري عما في القلب إلا الله.
And nobody knows that which is in the heart except Allah.
ونحن نرى أو نعلم أن هناك بعض الناس هدانا الله وإياهم يغير حتى ما في قلبه ويقول أنه مكره. نعم.
And we know of some people who will even change that which is in their own hearts just to say that they are compelled.
ثم الإكراه أيضا لا يكون في تعدي على غيره.
And then being forced to do an action or being compelled to do an action, this doesn't mean that you now oppress or exceed the limits of somebody else, oppress somebody else.
يعني هذا مثلا أكره على قتل هذا.
So for example, this one, he was forced or compelled to kill this one.
فهل له أن يقتل هذا حتى يبقي على نفسه؟
So is it permissible for him to kill this person so he can save himself?
لا.
No.
لأن هذا يتعدى إلى غيره.
Because now he is oppressing and taking the right of this one.
أحمد رحمه الله عندما أكره على القول بخلق القرآن هل أحمد رحمه الله كان مكره؟ نقول لا، ليس له أن يقول بهذا، لأنه لو قال هذه الكلمة لتعدى هذا إلى غيره وظلت الأمة. نعم، ولهذا سمي الإمام أحمد بإمام أهل السنة والجماعة. نعم، لأنه وقف ضد الفتنة. نعم.
So Imam Ahmad, he was compelled and forced to say that the Quran is created in his time. And did Imam Ahmad rahimullah do this? No. Because if he did this, if he thought that he was compelled and forced to do this, then this would have oppressed other people. Why? Because the other people would have been misguided. And therefore he didn't say this, even though he was forced to do it. And for this reason, Imam Ahmad, may Allah have mercy upon him, he was called the Imam of Ahl Sunnah.
كذلك لا يزيد.
And also a person doesn't exceed the limits.
يعني أكره على سب رجل واحد من المسلمين.
Meaning, a person is compelled or forced to insult one particular Muslim.
فسب عشرة أو مئة أو كل أهل الإسلام.
So therefore he begins to insult 10 or 100 all of the people of Islam.
نقول أنت مكره على واحد أما البقية لست مكره عليهم فتؤاخذ بهذا.
We say to him that you were forced or compelled to insult one person, but you weren't forced to, you weren't first or forced or compelled to insult all of the people of Islam, and therefore you will be taken upon this.
ثم أيضا قال العلماء رحمه الله في المكره أنه يعرض ما استطاع يعني لا يصرح بالكفر يعني يأتي بأمور يعني هي في الظاهر أن هؤلاء يصدقوه على ما أكره عليه وهو في هذا الكلام ليس بناطق بالكفر. نعم، مع أنه مكره لكن مع هذا يعرض، كما في فتنة الإمام أحمد رحمه الله كان العلماء الذين يعني كان في حقهم أنهم على الإكراه كانوا يقولون التوراة والإنجيل والزبور هذه أي الأصابع مخلوقة، واقصد بهذا الأصابع، وكان هؤلاء يعني من أكرههم يظنوا أنهم أرادوا القرآن والكتب المنزلة من السماء. نعم.
And also the scholars they have mentioned, may Allah have mercy upon them, regarding a person being compelled and forced, that even though a person is compelled or forced to do an act of kufr or say a statement of kufr, that he tries to resist as much as possible, or tries to find a way out as much as possible. Even by saying something which they think that he has said a word of kufr, but in reality he hasn't said it. Like for example that which occurred at the time of Imam Ahmad. When the people were forcing Imam Ahmad to say that the Quran...
Imam Ahmad. الذين مع الإمام أحمد.
When the people were forcing the scholars who were with Imam Ahmad to say that the Quran is created, they would say the Quran and the Torah and the Injil, these are created. And they're referring to their fingers being created, not the Quran and the Torah and Injil.
نعم ثم إن تحققت هذه الشروط فهو مكره.
So then, if these conditions are fulfilled and met, then we can say that this person has been compelled or forced.
نعم ذكر الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى في مسألة يعني حلق اللحى في بعض الدول.
Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentions regarding the issue of being forced to shave the beard in some countries.
يقول الإشكال في أول من حلق اللحية أنه تجرأ وحلق اللحى ثم بعد هذا سنة سيئة فتابعه الناس على هذا. نعم.
He said,
لو صبر لبقي الكل. نعم.
Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah said, then this issue, the real problem is the first person who shaved his beard when he was pressurized to do so. And had he been patient and not done so, then people wouldn't have followed him. But because he gave up and he shaved his beard, he therefore introduced an evil action and therefore people followed him.
ولا يفهم هذا الخروج على الحكام لكن يفهم من هذا أن بعض الناس لأدنى أذية أو أدنى ضرر يترك كل الدين والله سبحانه وتعالى قال ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله فإذا أوذي في الله جعل فتنة الناس كعذاب الله أي جعل الخوف من الناس أشد من الخوف من الله. نعم.
And this doesn't mean that a person starts rebelling against the Muslim rulers. What this means is that some people, any little harm that comes to them, they completely turn away from the religion of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said regarding those people who, when they are tested or afflicted by something, that they consider the fear that they have of the people is greater than the fear that they have of Allah.
Yeah. في المعروف ولا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق.
And obedience can only be done in goodness, and there is no obedience to creation when there is disobedience to the Creator.
فنسمع ونطيع ما لم نؤمر بمعصية.
So we hear and we obey as long as we are not ordered to do an act of disobedience.
نعم. ثم قال رحمه الله تعالى.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, said that all of these matters, وَكُلُّهَا, and all of these matters are the most dangerous and yet most common of what takes place.
نعم. هذا فيه شاهد أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى يرى أن النواقض ليست محصورة بعشرة. نعم.
So in this
من
is
أعظم ما يكون ومن هذه تبعيضية. نعم.
So in this is an evidence that the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he considers that these 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam, they only 10 from many more matters which invalidate a person's Islam. And the min that was used here, وَكُلُّهَا مِنْ أَعْظَمْ, is min التَّبْعِيضِيَة, meaning they're saying that these matters are from more matters. There are more matters than these are from amongst them.
أي بعض النواقض. لا كل النواقض. نعم.
Meaning some of the matters which invalidate, not all of the matters which invalidate.
ومن أكثر ما يكون وقوعا كذلك هذا فيه شاهد أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى يرى أن النواقض ليست محصورة بعشرة. نعم.
أقرأ.
نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said, فَيَنْبَغِي لِلْمُسْلِمِ, he said, so it is befitting that a Muslim takes caution and fears for himself regarding these matters.
نعم. أي يجب على المسلم.
Meaning that it is obligatory upon a Muslim.
وهذا فيه أن العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى يعبروا أحيانا بينبغي وهي مثل يجب لكن حتى لا يكون هذا العالم يعني يندرج تحت قوله سبحانه وتعالى ولا تقولوا لما تصف ألسنتكم الكذب هذا حلال وهذا حرام فهم وعلى هذا الأئمة منهم الإمام مالك رحمه الله الجميع يقول دائما ينبغي ولا ينبغي ولا يقول حلال وحرام ورع ونسمع بعض الطلاب اليوم هدانا الله إياهم لا يبالي يفتي تكلم ويحلل ويحرم ويكفر ويفسق ويضلل ويرمي بالنفاق ويصنع ويصنع نعم في أمور يتوقف فيها كبار العلماء نعم في أمور لو وقعت زمن أمير المؤمنين عمر رضي الله عنه لجمع لها كبار الصحابة كما تسمع اليوم في بعض البلدان من الخروج على الحكام ومن المظاهرات واستباحة الأموال والأنفس والأعراض. نعم.
And here the author, may Allah mercy upon him, he used the word ينبغي, which means that it is befitting or appropriate that Muslim takes caution. And what he meant by this was that it is obligatory. But he didn't use the word obligatory, yajib. And this was because the author, rahimahullah, he wanted to act or implement the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُوا أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ
أَلْسِنَتُكُمُ الْكَذِبُ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ لِتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبُ
That نعم. They should not allow their tongues to say that this is halal and this is haram, and yet they are lying upon Allah. So instead of saying yajib, obligatory, and out of his fear and his wara, his fear and his modesty in front of Allah, he didn't say the word obligatory. He said it is yambaghi, it is appropriate. And this is the way of many of the scholars, including Imam Malik rahimullah. Often Imam Malik will say yambaghi wa la yambaghi. This is befitting or this is not befitting. Meaning, and he means by this, that this is obligatory or this is not obligatory, because he fears saying something which might be a lie upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Shaykh said that unfortunately we find some students in some of the countries, and they say that this is halal, this is haram, this is disbelief, go out against the rulers. This, and he considers people as disbelievers or hypocrites or misguided, or he throws accusations at them. And maybe in this type of issue, Umar radiallahu anhu, who was Amir al-Mu'mineen, he would gather all of the major companions, the old senior companions, to request their opinion. And yet the student in this country, he doesn't care at all, and he says these things.
فنحن الآن عندما ندرس متن نواقض الإسلام أو القواعد الأربع أو الأصول الثلاثة أو كتاب التوحيد أو هذه الكتب التي يذكر فيها أنواع الشرك الأكبر وأنواع الشرك الأصغر وأنواع الكفر وما إلى ذلك لابد أن نعلم شيء مهم جدا. نعم.
So now when we study these texts like نواقض الإسلام, the matters which invalidate persons Islam, or الأصول الثلاثة, the three fundamental principles, or القواعد الأربع, the four fundamental principles, or كتاب التوحيد, or the other books in which we study that this is shirk akbar, this is shirk asghar, this is kufr akbar, this is kufr asghar, there's an important matter that we have to take note of and pay attention to.
أننا نريد أن نتعلم الآن حكم العمل ونحكم على الفعل. أما الحكم على الفاعل فلا بد من الرجوع إلى العلماء الربانيين. نعم.
That we, when we're studying this, then we only want to seek knowledge regarding the ruling on the action itself. The action itself, not the person who is doing the action. So if we're now going to pass a ruling on the person who's doing the action, then we have to refer back to the ulama al-rabbaniyin, the old senior scholars who have knowledge and they act upon their knowledge.
فإذا كفر العلماء كفرنا.
So if the scholars, they consider somebody to be a disbeliever, then we say he's a disbeliever.
وإذا توقف العلماء توقفنا.
And if the scholars, they stop and they don't take a position, then we stop and we don't take a position.
وإذا حكم العلماء أن كل من فعل هذا فهو كافر مثل سب الرب. نعم. هذا ما هو معلوم من الدين بالضرورة. لا إشكال في هذا. لكن العلماء يتوقفوا في مسائل يفتي فيها اليوم من لا يعرف بالعلم أصلا. نعم.
And if the scholars, if they say that anybody and everybody who does a particular action is a kafir, then we say this. Like the scholar said, that the one who insults Allah is a kafir. Anybody who does this, and therefore we say anybody. But now, in our time, we have issues in which the scholars remain silent about. The scholars don't speak about, and they don't take positions about, and yet a student will talk about.
إن كنا لا نستطيع أن نفتي في مسألة من مسائل الطلاق.
If we're not able to give a fatwa, to give an Islamic ruling on an issue which is relates to divorce, at-talaq,
خروج مرأة من عصمة رجل لا نقدر عليه.
So, removing a woman from the guardianship and the protection of a man, we're not able to give a ruling regarding this matter.
فما بالك خروج إنسان من الدين بالكلية.
Then how about removing a person from the religion in its entirety?
استباحة الدماء.
making his blood and his life lawful.
الأموال.
Wealth.
الأعراض.
Honor.
وليس عنكم يعني هذا ببعيد ما يعني وقع في بعض الدول من قتل لا يدري فيما قتل ولا يدري القاتل فيما قتل، كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يكثر القتل. وتكلم الرويبضة من لا يعرف بالعلم أصلا، وتكلم كبار العلماء ولا أسمع لهم. نعم.
And this isn't something which is distant or far from you. Even now in some countries, a person is killed and he doesn't know what he was killed for. A person kills and yet he doesn't know why he is killing. So killing takes place. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that during the end of time, yukthir al-qatal, there will be much killing. And the ignorant, lowly young people, they will speak.
Allahumma hadina fi man hadait wa'afina fi man afait. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرد أهل الإسلام إليه ردا جميلا.
آمين.
نعم. ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بعد أن ذكر هذه المسائل أخذ يختم هذه الرسالة المباركة بالدعاء. نعم. فقال:
And after this, when the author finished mentioning these matters, then he sought to end his treatise, the blessed treatise, by making a dua, a supplication.
نعم. وهذا فيه said, وقال وهذا فيه أن أهل السنة والجماعة جعلنا الله إياكم منهم يتبرؤون من حولهم ومن قوتهم. يعني لم يقل أنا لا أقع في هذه النواقض وأنا رأس من رؤوس أهل السنة والجماعة وكذا وكذا مما يقول بعض الناس، لا، تبرأ من حولي ومن قوتي. وبعد هذا أخذ يدعو ويفتقر إلى الله بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يجنب الوقوع ويجنبنا وإياه الوقوع في هذه النواقض. نعم.
So then when the author, when he finished this blessed treatise with a supplication, this shows the way of the scholars of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, that they always belittle their own power and their own might and their will. So the author here, he showed his need and poverty in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he freed himself, or he belittled his own power and his own might. So he didn't say that, you know, I am an imam and I have authored this and I will never fall into this. Rather, he belittles himself in this way.
No.
So he said, or the dua that he made, he said, we seek refuge in Allah from anything that causes his anger and his painful punishment.
نعم. ثم صلى على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وختمت هذه الرسالة. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يختم لي ولكم ولكل المسلمين بالتوحيد. آمين. والله أعلم. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
And then he finalized this blessed treatise by sending peace and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I supplicate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives me and you the ending of at-tawheed. Ameen.